13 News Now is your back-to-school station. Public schools will start soon with unique challenges for students and teachers. Studies show the pandemic has driven a million more kids into poverty. 4 million kids now live in homes without access to a computer. Some Black and Latinx kids could be as much as a year behind white students. And tonight, anchor David Allen takes a deeper look at the inequities in education and why the pandemic may be an opportunity for lasting change.
Stop cutting us off. I'm serious. Put the parenting decisions back where they belong.
All of the shouting over face masks,
and masks are needed,
may be drowning out a more important debate. The debate not just about the health of students, but also their well-being. The pandemic has shined a bright light on inequities in public education. Inequities rooted in the digital divide, deepened by poverty, and threatening to create a lost generation.
I mean, there is so much literature that shows that disadvantaged kids, particularly minoritized kids, kids with disabilities, youth and children from low-income backgrounds, can academically thrive if they are in supportive school environment.
Dr. Nazneen Khan is an associate professor of sociology at Randolph-Macon College. Her most recent research documented the unequal impacts of COVID-19 on kids.
And skipping school entirely is only slightly less effective than online learning has been for kids in marginalized communities.
Inequities are not new to Portsmouth Public Schools, the area's most urban district.
We won't fix everything this school year with what we've lost over the past 15 months being in a virtual platform.
Dr. Bracey says when schools switched suddenly to virtual learning last year, the district scrambled to find more than 4,500 Chromebooks for elementary school students. School buses with hotspots rolled into neighborhoods to support families that could not afford internet service.
We have some unique challenges here, and it didn't take the pandemic to bring that to light. You know, we've been dealing with that for years.
Portsmouth has a high number of students who rely on their schools for meals and who start school behind academically.
We have kids that are coming out of neighborhoods and communities that don't have any books in the home. Their first introduction to textbooks or any type of book is when they come to school.
Dr. Khan says many students will return to classrooms this fall academically unprepared for their grade level and who will have experienced chronic stress at home.
A lot of kids, especially Hispanic boys and girls, have had to drop out of school to help support their families during these economic employment, or they're watching younger siblings, especially Latinx, Latinx girls. They're watching younger siblings because their parents are in, essential jobs.
Dr. Khan says to close those inequity gaps, the nation will need to address the structural causes of poverty: pay gaps, minimum wage, and mental health challenges. But perhaps there's something good that's come from the pandemic and the inequities it's revealed. There's a heightened awareness about how we fund school divisions that don't have the resources their neighbors have. The American Rescue Plan helped Portsmouth to purchase critical technology. Estimates are 50% of children will be lifted out of poverty by the child tax credit. For now, both are short-term fixes and not a long-term strategy to deal with the widening gap between the haves and have-nots.
I hope that there will be enough data and evidence to demonstrate the good that's brought about by those programs that we can continue them.
And Dr. Khan says post-World War II, the country made significant investments to save children, and yet not all children benefited. She hopes that will not be the case when we look back on the pandemic.